Hello students, how are you? Hope you all are healthy and safe at your home. I'm Shweta Jain representing Shiv Jyoti Educational Group Kota. So children, today I'm here to teach you science, and today we will do the revision of chapter number 9, adaptations in animals. So children, different points to remember in this chapter are habitat, types of animals, that there are two types of animals, invertebrates and vertebrates. Then in this chapter you have also learnt about adaptations. So adaptations in animals, adaptations for environment, adaptations for food, adaptations for protection and endangered animals. So now we will revise each of these points one by one. So children, here the home or natural environment in which an animal lives is called as its habitat. So what is habitat? It is the home or the natural environment where an animal lives. Now animals are divided in two categories. These two categories are invertebrates and vertebrates. So invertebrates are the animals that do not have backbone. So children, these are the animals which do not have backbone, and some of the examples of such animals are snails, spider, insects and worms, like butterfly, cockroach, ant, beetle, earthworm. These all are the examples of invertebrates. The another category is vertebrates. So these are the animals which have backbone. Animals that have backbone are vertebrates, and vertebrates are further divided into five different categories. So these five categories are fish, amphibians, reptiles, birds and mammals. So children, fish are the animals which live only in the water, and they have fins which help them to swim, and some of the examples are cod, shark and salmon. Second category is amphibians. These are the animals which can live on land as well as in water, and these animals breathe through lungs when they are on land, and when they are in water they breathe through their moist skin, and some of the examples are frog, toads and salamanders. The third category of vertebrates is reptiles. These are the animals which have dry and scaly skin, and some of the examples are snake, lizard and crocodile. So children, snake do not have legs. They crawl along the ground, but lizards and crocodile have legs to move. Then fourth category of vertebrates is birds. So birds are those whose body is covered with feathers. Okay, so the body of birds is covered with feathers, and most of the birds fly with the help of their wings. Another features of birds are that they have boat shaped body. So the shape of the body of bird is boat shape. They have hollow bones and light body. Okay, some of the examples are pigeon, sparrow, crow and parrot. Now children, there are some birds which cannot fly. These birds are called flightless birds, and examples are ostrich, penguin and kiwi. Now the last category of vertebrates is mammals. So mammals are the animals that give birth to young ones. The mothers feed their young ones with their own milk. They have hair all over their body, and they have four limbs and external ear. So these are some of the features of mammals. What are they? That is, they give birth to young ones. Mothers feed their young ones with their own milk. They have hair all over their body, and they have four limbs, means two legs and two hands, and external ears. Mammals breathe through the lungs, and some of the examples of mammals are human beings, cow, goat, elephant, lion, zebra and kangaroo. Now children, whale and dolphin are also mammals, but they live in the sea, so they are called as sea mammals. Whale and dolphin frequently come out of water to breathe in air. So children, these were the five different categories of vertebrates. Now we move to adaptations. So children, the body features that help animals to survive in their environment are called adaptations. So what are adaptations over here? These are the body features that help animals to survive in their environment. These features are called as adaptations. Now animals adapt themselves for different types of conditions, like they adapt themselves to the environment, they adapt themselves for the food, and they adapt themselves for protection. So let us come to adaptations to environment. So children, there are different types of habitats found on this earth, like land, water. So on the basis of the habitat, animals are adapted accordingly. Like first category is terrestrial animals. So these are the animals that live on land. So children, what are terrestrial animals over here? These are the animals that live on land. They have legs to move and lungs to breathe air. Now, on land also there are different environmental conditions, like at some places there is hot desert. So the animals like camel, they are adapted to live in hot desert conditions. And at some places there is extreme cold. So animals like polar bear, penguin and seals, they are adapted to live in the extreme cold conditions. Then there is yak, which lives on cold mountains and it has long hairs on its body. Now there are two terms, that is hibernation and estivation. So children, hibernation here means winter sleep. So children, animals like bears and frogs sleep for several months to protect themselves from the cold conditions. So this type of winter sleep is called as hibernation. And some animals like land snails and salamanders, they go for long sleep during summer months. So such type of summer sleep is called estivation. Now we come to another type of animals on the basis of habitat, that is aquatic animals. Just now we have seen terrestrial animals which live on land. Now the animals that live in water are called aquatic animals. So what are aquatic animals here? These are the animals that live in water. So some of the examples are fish, octopus, turtle and crab. And these animals have gills for breathing in water and they have fins or paddle like feet to swim in water. Another category is amphibians. Now these are the animals which can live both on land and in water. And some of the examples are frogs, toads and salamanders, and they have webbed feet to swim in water. The next category is arboreal animals. These are the animals that spend most of their time on trees. So what are arboreal animals here? The animals that spend most of their time on trees, and some of the examples are monkey, orangutan and koala bear. Now another category is aerial animals. These are the animals that spend most of their time in the air. So children, what are aerial animals here? These are the animals that spend most of their time in air. They have a pair of limbs modified as wings which help them to fly. So there are four limbs. Front limbs are modified into wings which help them to fly. They have hollow bones which make their body light. So this is another feature of the aerial animals, that their body is very light in weight and their bones are hollow, and their boat shaped body can cut through the air easily, and their body is boat shaped, so they can easily fly in the air. Now all birds except flightless birds are the examples of aerial animals. And one more example of aerial animal is there, that is bat. That is not a bird, it is a mammal, but it is a flying mammal. Now we come to adaptations for food. So children, different animals eat different type of food. So depending on the food they eat, they are further categorized in different groups. So these groups are, first is herbivores, the animals which eat only the plants or their parts. Some of the examples are cow, horse, deer, zebra and elephant. And these animals have sharp front teeth for cutting and biting and strong flat teeth at the back of their mouth for chewing and grinding. So these are the adaptations of the herbivores. Now we come to carnivores. So these are the animals that eat flesh of other animals. They are called as carnivores. So these animals have very sharp teeth for tearing out the flesh of their prey. And some of the examples are lion, tiger, jackal and leopard. Then third category is omnivores. Now these are the animals that eat flesh as well as plants. So children, what are omnivores here? Animals that eat both plants and the flesh of other animals. And some of the examples are dog, cat, bear, crow and human beings. Now, another category is scavengers. So, scavengers are the animals that feed on the flesh of dead animals. So children, these are the animals which eat the flesh of the dead animals. Okay. And examples of scavengers are vulture and hyena. So, hyena and vulture both are scavengers. Then the next category is parasites. These are the animals that live on or inside the body of other animals for food. They are called as parasites and they get their food by sucking the blood of their host. And some of the examples are tapeworm, flatworm, lice, ticks and fleas. Now we come to adaptations for protection. So children, some animals have adapted themselves so that they can get protected in the environment where they live. So animals like zebra, tiger, grasshopper, stick insect, polar bear and Arctic fox can merge with their surroundings. And some animals like chameleons can change their body color according to their surroundings. So children, here the ability of animals to merge with their surroundings or change their body color so that they are hard to be spotted is called camouflage. So what is camouflage here, or how do animals protect themselves? What they do, they either change their body color according to the surroundings, or they surround themselves, or they merge themselves with the surrounding. They blend themselves with the surrounding. Some of the examples are like zebra and tiger. They have stripes on their body, so they blend themselves in the surroundings where they live and they are hard to be spotted there. Similarly, grasshopper, it is green in color, so we are unable to see it easily when it lives on the leaves. Stick insect looks like stick, so when it sits on the branches of tree, it is unable to spot it easily. Polar bear and Arctic fox are white in color, so they also show camouflage. And another animal, that is chameleon. Chameleon can change their body color according to their surroundings, so it also show camouflage. So some of the examples of the animals that show camouflage are zebra, tiger, grasshopper, stick insect, polar bear and Arctic fox and chameleon. Now, besides camouflaging, some animals have developed some other features also for their protection. Like some animals like deer and kangaroo can run very fast to escape from their enemies. Porcupines have sharp and pointed quills which protect them from their enemies. Tortoise and snails have hard shells. When they face the danger, they go into their shells. Now we come to endangered animals. So children, there are some animals which are at a risk of getting disappeared from the earth. And why they are at this risk? Because of the activities like cutting forest and hunting of animals. Animals are in danger of dying out. So some animals which have disappeared completely from the earth are called extinct animals. So what are extinct animals? These are the animals like dodo and dinosaurs which have disappeared from the earth completely. They are called extinct animals. And there are some animals like giant panda and tiger which are in danger of becoming extinct. They are called as endangered animals. So these are the animals which are present on the earth but in very less number and are in danger of becoming extinct. So we call them as endangered animals. And examples of endangered animals are giant panda and tiger. So children, this is all about the explanation part of this chapter. Now we will revise the internal questions. So first internal question is, what are adaptations? The body features that help animals to survive in their environment. So children, what are adaptations here? These are the body features that help animals to survive in the environment where it lives. Now question number two is, what kind of animals live on land? So the animals that live on land are called as terrestrial animals. So spelling of terrestrial animals here is T-E-R-R-E-S-T-R-I-A-L, terrestrial animals. Now question number three is, what are arboreal animals? So these are the animals that spend most of their time on trees. So children, now let us revise the book work and copy work. So all of you open page number 78 of your book. Let's come to the exercise, fill in the blanks with the correct words. Here you can see some words are given in the help box which you can use for filling the blanks. Animals that do not have a backbone are called. So children, the animals which do not have backbone, they are called invertebrates. Dash have fins to swim in water. So here we can see from the given words, fish is the animal which have fins to swim in water because fish live in water. A toad is an dash. So toad is an animal which can live in water as well as on land. So it is an amphibian. So here we will write amphibian. Dash reproduce by giving birth to babies. So children, this is the characteristic feature of mammals, that they reproduce by giving birth to babies. So here I have written mammals. Dash have hollow bones which make their bodies light. So children, birds have hollow bones which make their bodies light so that they can fly easily in the air. Now we come to the next exercise on page number 81. It is tick the correct answer. So you all know that four options are given and you have to choose one among them. Which of the following is not an invertebrate? Spider, cockroach, lion, housefly. So children, you can see that spider, cockroach, housefly, these all are the insects and very small animals. So they all are invertebrates, but lion is a vertebrate. Which of the following is a reptile? Shark, beetle, crocodile, frog. So children, shark is a fish, beetle is an insect, crocodile is a reptile over here, and frog is an amphibian. So the correct answer is crocodile. Which of the following has hollow bones? So we all know that birds have hollow bones so that they can fly easily in the air. So cow, dog and fish are not the correct options for this. Bird is the correct option. Which of the following is an aquatic animal? Octopus, lizard, crow or camel? So children, here you can see octopus lives in water, lizard is a reptile, crow is a bird and camel is a mammal which live on land. So the animals which live in water are called aquatic animals. So correct answer is octopus. Which of the following animals show camouflage? So you all know that camouflage is the ability through which organisms blend themselves into their surroundings, they merge themselves into the surroundings where they live. So here, hyena, zebra, ostrich or whale. So the correct answer is zebra because it has stripes on its body. Now we come to the next exercise. Write T for true and F for false statements. So children, an earthworm has a backbone. So is it a false statement or a true statement? This is a false statement because earthworm is an invertebrate. All the worms are invertebrates. They do not have backbone. So this is a wrong statement. A tapeworm lives inside the host's body. So children, this is the correct statement because tapeworm is a parasite which lives inside the host body. Now, hyena is a scavenger. So children, this is a correct statement because hyena is an animal which eats the flesh of dead animals. So it is a scavenger. A grasshopper and leaf insect show camouflage. This is also a correct statement because grasshopper and leaf insect both are green in color which resembles to the leaves. So they show camouflage. Koala bear is an aquatic animal. This is a wrong statement because koala bear is an arboreal animal. It spends most of its time on trees. Now we come to the next exercise. Name the following. So two examples of vertebrates, fish and bird. You can give any two examples because we have studied five different categories of vertebrates. They are fish, amphibians, reptiles, birds and mammals. Two flightless birds. So flightless birds are the birds which cannot fly. Examples are kiwi and ostrich. Two examples of fish. You can write any two examples of fish. I have written over here shark and cod. The group of animals live both on land and in water. So children, the animals which live both on land as well as in water are called amphibians. Two examples of camouflaging animals. You can give any two examples of camouflaging animals. Here I have written polar bear and stick insects. So many examples are also there, like zebra, tiger. Now we come to the next exercise. Circle the odd one out. Here you can see cow, tapeworm, dog and parrot. So here tapeworm is a parasite. So this is the odd one. Lion, tiger, deer, jackal. You can see the three are carnivores, but deer is a herbivore. Chameleon, zebra, grasshopper and elephant. So we can see here chameleon, zebra and grasshopper, they all show camouflage, but elephant do not show. Polar bear, penguin, seal and camel. So here polar bear, penguin, seal, they all lives in the extreme cold climatic conditions, but camel lives in the hot desert. Sparrow, ostrich, parrot, pigeon. Here sparrow, parrot and pigeon can fly easily, but ostrich is a flightless bird. Now let us revise the copy work. So first we'll start with define. So define the following. First definition is hibernation. Animals like bear and frog sleep for several months to protect themselves from the cold. Such winter sleep is called hibernation. Aerial animals. Animals that spend most of the time in the air are called aerial animals. Now we come to answer the following questions. So question number one is, write the two features of aerial animals. So children, you all know that aerial animals are the animals which spend most of their time in air. So their features are, they have a pair of limbs modified as wings which helps them to fly, and they have hollow bones which make their bodies light. Question number two is, differentiate between vertebrates and invertebrates. So here, vertebrates are the animals which have a backbone. Example is a snake, fish, etc. Invertebrates, they do not have a backbone. Example is butterfly and spider. Now question number three is, give any three adaptations for protection. So deer and kangaroo can run very fast to escape from their enemies. Porcupines have sharp and pointed quills. Tortoise and snails have hard shells. Now explain in brief the types of animals on the basis of food they eat. So children, animals are categorized in five different categories on the basis of food they eat. First is herbivores, eat plants only. Carnivores, eat flesh of other animals only. Omnivores, eat both plants and flesh of other animals. Scavengers, eat flesh of dead animals. Parasites, live on or inside the body of other animals for food. Now the next question is, explain how aquatic animals are different from amphibians. So here answer is, aquatic animals live in water. Example is fish, turtles, etc. Amphibians are the animals which live both on land and in water. Example are frogs, toads, etc. So children, this is all about the revision of chapter number 9, adaptations in animals. I hope you all have understood it well. So go through the chapter well and learn the book work and copy work along with internal questions thoroughly. Till then, have a nice day.